You fill up my senses like a night in a forest, like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like a sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses, come fill me again. Come, let me love you, let me give my life. Let me drown in your laughter, let me die in your arms, let me lay down beside you, let me always be with you. Come, let me love you, come love me. Like a sleepy blue ocean, you fill up my senses, come fill me again.
How things always come back around full circle. This particular song seems still to be the story of my life in many respects. Perhaps you'll sing it with me. All my bags are packed, I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. The taxi's waiting, he's blown his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could die. So kiss me and smile for me, tell me that you'll wait for me, hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane, don't know when I'll be back again. Oh babe, I hate to go. There's so many times I let you down, so many times I played around. I tell you now, they don't mean a thing. Every place I go, I'll think of you. Every song I sing, I'll sing for you. When I come back, I'll bring your wedding ring. So kiss me and smile for me, Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. Now the time has come to leave you one more time. Let me kiss you and close your eyes. I'll be on my way. Dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the times I won't have to say. Oh, kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. Good night, my friends. God bless you all. As a storm across the valley, clouds are rolling in. The afternoon is heavy on your shoulders. There's a truck out on the four lane, a mile or more away. The whining of his wheels just makes it colder. He's an hour away from writing all your prayers up in the sky. 10 days on the road are barely gone. There's a fire softly burning, yes, supper's on the stove. It's the light in your eyes makes him warm. Everybody's singing. Hey, it's good to be back home again. Like a long lost friend. Yes, and hey, it's good to be back home again. There's all the news to tell him. How do you spend your time? What's the latest thing the neighbors say? And your mother called last Friday, and sunshine made her cry. You felt the baby move just yesterday. Hey, it's good to be back home again. Yes, it is. Sometimes this old farm feels like a long lost friend. Yes, and hey, it's good to be back home again. All the time that I can lay this tired old body down, feel your fingers you. It's the little things that make a house a home, yeah. Like a fire softly burning and supper on the stove. The light in your eyes that keeps me warm. You folks singing. So far, feels like a long lost friend. Hey, it's good to be back home again. I said, hey, it's good to be back home again. Frosting on the window pane, sorrow in your eyes. The stars are fading quietly, night is nearly gone. So you turn away from me, and tears begin to come, and it's goodbye again. I'm sorry to be leaving you, goodbye again. As if you didn't know, it's goodbye again. I wish you could tell me, why do we always fight when I have to go? Seems a shame to leave you now. You lay so soft and warm. I long to lay me down again, hold you in my arms. And I long to kiss the tears away, give you back your smile. But other voices beckon me, for goodbye again. I'm sorry to be leaving you, goodbye again. As if you didn't know, it's goodbye again. I wish you could tell me, why do we always fight when I have to go? Go and see some friends of mine, some that I don't know, some who aren't familiar with my name. It's something that's inside of me, not hard to understand. If anyone If your hours are empty now, who am I to blame? You think if I were always here, our love would be the same. As it is, the time we have is worth the time alone. Lying by your side, the greatest peace ever known, but it's goodbye again. I'm sorry to be leaving you, goodbye again. As If you didn't know, it's goodbye again. I wish you could tell me, why do we always fight when I have to go?
I was on an airplane going to India to pay my respects to Swami Muktananda, who was a dear friend to me and teacher to millions of people around the world. And on the airplane that I was traveling on, there were all of these people who were from Columbia Pictures. And they were on their way to New Delhi for the premiere, the world premiere of a movie about Gandhi, which I had not even known was under production. And it was amazing to me that in this incredibly powerful media of film, of movies, that at that particular time, about 1985, if I remember correctly, that a movie about this man's life had been made. And as we descended into New Delhi, I looked out the window and saw a beautiful full moon. And somehow it struck me as to what has occurred in India over the years and how India is now, to a large degree, feeding itself, producing more than it consumes, when we had thought that it was going to end up being an incredible disaster. Not to say that there are not many, a great many hungry and starving people in that country still today. In any case, it was the beginning of a song that has come to mean a great deal to me, and which I think exemplifies the moment at hand, if you will, and what we're here about. And I would like to leave you with this thought tonight as you go home. There's a full moon over India, and Gandhi lives again. And who's to say you have to lose for someone else to win? In the eyes of all the people, the look is much the same. For the first is just the last one. When you play a deadly game, it's about time we realize it. It's all of us or none. It's about time we recognize it. These changes in the weather. It's about time. It's about changes. It's about time. There's a light in the Vatican window for all the world to see. And a voice cries in the wilderness. Sometimes he speaks for me. I suppose I love him most of all when he kneels to kiss the land. With his lips upon our mother's breast, he makes his strongest stand. It's about time we start to face it. The earth is our only home. It's about time we start to see it. We can't make it here on our own. It's about time we start to listen. There's a man who is my brother, I just don't know his name, but I know his home and family, because I know we feel the same. And it hurts me when he's hungry and when his children cry. I too am a father,
and that little one is mine. It's about time we begin it to turn the world around. It's about time we start to make it the dream we've always known. It's about time we start to live it.
Stand alone on some forgotten highway, traveled by many, remembered by few. Looking for something that I can believe in. Looking for something that I'd like to do with my life. There's nothing behind. Nothing that ties me to something that might have been true yesterday. Tomorrow is open. Right now it seems to be more than enough to just be here today. And I don't know what the future is holding in store. Don't know where I'm going. I'm not sure where I've been. There's a spirit that guides me, a light that shines for me. My life is worth the living. I don't need to see the end. Sweet, sweet surrender. Remembered by few. Looking for something that I can believe in. Looking for something that I'd like to do with my life. There's nothing behind me. Nothing that ties me to something that might have been true yesterday. Tomorrow is open. Right now it seems to be more than enough to just be here today. Yes, and I don't know what the future is holding in store. Don't know where I'm going. I'm not sure where I've been. There's a spirit that guides me, life that shines for me. My life is worth the living. I don't need to see the end. Your sweet, sweet surrender. Live, live without care. Fish in the water, like a bird in the air. Sweet, sweet surrender. Why don't we live?
without care. Like a fish, just like a fish in the water. Like a bird in the air. And I sweet, 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 sweet surrender. Come on and live, live without care. Like a fish in the water.
Coming home to a place he'd never been before. Left the yesterday behind him, you might say he was born again. Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy. Sunshine in my eyes can make me cry. Sunshine on the water looks so lovely. Sunshine almost always makes me high. If I had a day that I could give you, I'd give to you a day just like today. If I had a song that I could sing for you, I'd sing a song to make you feel this way. Sing it with me. Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy. Sunshine in my eyes can make me cry. Almost always makes me high. Sunshine almost all the time makes me high. Sunshine. almost always.
Thanks very much, everybody. Once again, good evening. Welcome to my little concert tonight here at the beautiful Apollo Victoria Theatre, London, England. Last night I thought I was back at Shepherd's Bush Green. You may notice we have television cameras here. They are filming the concert for BBC for broadcast later on, I guess in December. So that's kind of exciting. It's exciting to be back in London, folks. I'm very happy to be here with you. I'm especially pleased to be doing this tour of Europe in the particular format that we have presented here this evening. It's just me and my guitar, sort of the way it all started for me quite some time ago. And it's wonderful to me to be able to, you know, I want to make this just as special and as intimate as it can possibly be when you have a couple thousand people there, you know. I have a lot of songs I want to do for you tonight, some old ones that go all the way back to before I was with the Mitchell Trio, some brand new ones that haven't been recorded yet, and everything in between. You're invited to sing along at any time. You are requested to do the song that I'm doing. You never know, you know. I really want you to enjoy yourself. I had so much fun last night, boy. So I expect to do nothing but emulate or repeat what we did then. I want you to enjoy yourselves too. This is a song about a town unlike London. Back in the United States, some of you may recognize it. Saturday night in Toledo, Ohio is like being nowhere at all. All through the day, how the hours rush by. You sit in the park and you watch the grass die. Oh, but after the sunset, the dusk and the twilight, when shadows of night start to fall, they roll back the sidewalks precisely at 10, and people who live there are not seen again. Just two lonely truckers from Kearney, Nebraska, and a salesman from places unknown says unknown. All huddled together in downtown Toledo to spend their big night all alone. You ask how I know of Toledo, Ohio. Well, I spent a week there one day. They've got entertainment to dazzle your eyes. Go visit the bakery and watch the buns rise. Oh, but let's not forget that the folks of Toledo unselfishly gave us the scale. No springs, honest weight, that's the promise they made. So smile and be thankful next time you get weighed. And with and wet will, let this be our motto. Let's let the sleeping dogs lie. Let's let the sleeping dogs lie. That's a little better. And here's to the dogs of Toledo, Ohio. Ladies, we bid you goodbye. It's a terrible song. Terrible song. I did that song once in Toledo. Big mistake on my part. I didn't mean to upset anybody. You know, I think it's a very funny song. I think it's very well written. It's basically true. And I didn't mean to offend anybody with the song. And actually, 95% of the audience that night stood up and sang the song with me word for word. There were a few people, however, who were very upset with me. They came back after the show to tell me about it, came backstage, told me in no uncertain terms, actually bruised me up a little bit with their purses. Three of the biggest women I've ever seen in my life. Be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of hearts have been broken just because these words were spoken. I love you. Yes, I do. I love you. If you break my heart, I'll die. So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Sing it with me now. Be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Millions of hearts have been broken just because these words were. I love you, yes I do. I love you. If you break my heart, I'll die. So be sure it's true when you say I love you. It's a sin to tell a lie. Can you sing that part? Be sure, cross my heart, I hope to die. I'll never, never, never tell another white lie. Took my little girl out on a date last night. Next to her, gravel Gertie would've looked all right. Now I'm between the devil and the deep blue sea. Cause I said, baby, you look good to me. I told her I loved her, but oh, how I lied. Now she gets set to be my blushing bride. If she leads me to the altar, I'm sunk. Cause I cannot tell a preacher I was drunk. So Lord, have mercy on an old count sinner. Give me one more chance to let another guy win. Cross my heart, hope to die. Never, never, never tell her one more time. I'll never tell another white lie. But oh, the old dog. You guys aren't singing now. We're recording this concert for posterity. It's going to be on television, and you all aren't singing. It's okay. I'll cover for you. That song, It's a Sin to Tell a Lie, was first recorded by a fellow called Somethin' Smith. The group was Somethin' Smith and the Redheads. It was my mom's favorite song in the entire world. Well, all of these people don't know. Do you all know this? Some of them don't. Give me a break, huh? You know how when you're a little kid and your mom, you know, you hear that your mom needs a new refrigerator or something like that, and you say, boy, when I grow up, I'm going to get my mom a refrigerator. Well, for me, what I was going to do when I grew up was I was going to learn how to play that song and sing it for my mom. Some 20 years after that, I did a concert at Carnegie Hall in New York City, a beautiful old theater, and it was my first concert there. I flew my folks from Denver up to see the concert, had them sitting down here in the front, you know. At one point, I introduced them to the audience, had them stand up, put spotlights on them, embarrassed them to death. You know how moms are too. She was sitting out there. Did that song, dedicated it to her. Freaked her out. It was a wonderful occasion for me. It's a 12-string guitar, folks. if you hadn't noticed. Differentiated from the ordinary six-string guitar, this one has an additional six strings. The only problem with a 12-string guitar is keeping it in tune. When it's out of tune, the only problem is determining exactly which string it is that's out of tune. Then you tune the other 11 to that one. That's what I do. What do I know? This is a song written by Pete Seeger about Wales, western part of this beautiful country. And most specifically, it's about the mining villages in Wales and the church in those villages and how the bells and the steeples of each of these churches has a different color, a different character to it. This was always my solo song when I was with a group called the Mitchell Trio. I didn't get to play guitar very much when I was with them. And so for my solo number, I picked this to sort of work out a little bit. When Pete wrote it, I think his intention was to make the 12-string guitar sound like bells. We'll see. What will you give me? Say the bells of Rimini. Is there a hope for the future? Say the brown bells of Merthyr. Who made the mine owner? Say the black bells of Rhondda. And who robbed the miners? Say the grim bells of Blaenau. Plunder willy-nilly, say the bells of Caerphilly. They have fangs, they have teeth, shout the loud bells of Neath. Even God is uneasy, shout the moist bells of Swansea. And what will you give me? Say the sad bells of Rimini. Shout the bells of Newport. All would be well if say the green bells of Cardiff. Why so worried, sisters, why? Sing the silver bells of Wye.
will you give me? Say the sad bells of Rimini.
Thank you. I had a wonderful, wonderful experience this past September that I'd like to tell you all a little bit about. I was on a trail ride with about 40 other men from all over the United States, and we were in the southwestern part of Colorado, an area called the San Juan Wilderness Area. And we rode about of Durango up across the Continental Divide, spent about 5 days out in the wilderness camping out, getting rained on and snowed on and telling lies and stories. And it was just a great, great time for me and filled a truly deep, empty place that had built up in my heart. And one of the wonderful things that happened on this journey is I met a fellow named Dick Spencer, who happens to be probably the finest storyteller in the world. And he also, like my son Zachary, is half-blooded Indian. And he knows 3 Indian dialects. Now, the thing about all the tribes in the United States, all the different Indian tribes, and even within some tribes, the different families here and there, they had all had different languages. But when they met one another out in the wilderness someplace, they could communicate by sign language. And Dick taught me some sign language, and the most specific way that I can share it with you is one of the things that he taught me, which was the Lord's Prayer. Our, all of us, starting like this, and all of us, our Father, the mother is with a breast, our Father, which art, which one, which art in heaven, hallowed. They didn't really have a word for holy, but it was like the spirit, the mind meeting the spirit. Hallowed be thy name. How are you called? Watatashe. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom. Now, they didn't have a word for kingdom, so what that became was sort of like holy teepee. Thy kingdom come. Thy will, they didn't have a word for will, so it was thy way. Thy way be done. I like that. On earth, all of it. On earth, the same as it is in heaven. Give us, isn't that amazing? Give us this day our daily bread, patting the loaves, huh? And forgive us our trespasses. I didn't have a word really for trespasses or sins or like that, so it was like people who steal, take from you under the cover of night. Forgive us our trespasses the same as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation. I can't say it this way. I don't know why. But lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And evil you cast forcefully away. Don't throw it behind you. Dick was very specific about that. I don't know what that means, but it doesn't go with the prayer. Evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power, the same everywhere and always, huh? And the glory forever is the sun rolling across the sky. Amen. So it was a wonderful, wonderful experience learning that and getting up every morning at sunrise and singing it to myself as I did it out there in the wilderness. And then teaching my little boy Zachary how to do that. It's beautiful to watch that little brown guy do that. It's really beautiful. This was a week before I was going to do a television show that I've just completed with the Muppets. I take the entire Muppet gang on a camping trip. We filmed it all outdoors. I take Miss Piggy on a horseback ride. It's a great show. And I needed to write a song for the show, but no song came. On the last morning, we had to get up about 5:30 in the morning. It was still quite dark, and as a matter of fact, snowing on this particular day. And we had to ride up over the Continental Divide and down Elk Creek Canyon to meet a train that we were going to meet it was about 8 hours on horseback, actually. Elk Creek Canyon doesn't sound like much, does it? The most beautiful place I've ever seen. We came down off of above the tree line, the Continental Divide, down into this canyon, and it was incredibly treacherous. Throughout this journey, quite often we were able to ride side by side and tell stories and talk like that. This, you were single file, and you were paying attention to what you were doing because you could fall hundreds of feet. It would be all over if your horse missed a step or you weren't on top of it, you know? And you'd come around a corner and there'd be a waterfall coming off the canyon cliffs down here to the river below us. Go around another corner and here's one that spread into 10, 14 different falls and came tumbling down the mountain. Look up here and there's an elk standing up on top of the ridge. It was incredible. All of a sudden a song started happening for me. You know, I don't know what goes on with songs, folks. It's just the most amazing thing. There were these words going on in my head. And throughout the horseback ride, that last day, I wrote this song. You know I love the trail I'm on, the friends who ride with me, the country that we're passing through is a paradise to see. A haven for my spirit, the homeland of my dreams. My heart flies through the wilderness and on an eagle's wings. And though I love the waterfall, the way the river sings, from snow-capped peaks both proud and tall, through forests deep and green, the highway of the mountains, the lifeblood of the land, I can hear my mother speak to me and hold my father's hand. Durango Mountain Caballero, take me for a ride on the backbone of this mighty land, the Continental Divide, to the place where earth and heaven meet, the mountains and the skies.
in the heart of Colorado, Rocky Mountain High. Oh, I love the campfire and the circle that I'm in. The stories and the laughter, they should never, ever end. Forever in my memory, forever in my song. On a San Juan Mountain Trail ride, I'll carry
you're sitting on a horse, and you're a little bit afraid, and you're cold, and you're wet, and you're riding down this incredible, incredibly beautiful canyon that's so pretty it's moving you to tears, and all of a sudden there's words and a melody happening in your head. And you start sort of listening to that and playing with it, and here comes a line, and oh, that one doesn't work, and you change it around a little bit, and go along watching all of this stuff and sort of observing this thing that's going on inside your head. And all of it, as soon as you get down at the end of it, you pick up your guitar as quickly as you can and play it to see if this thing that was going on was just a fantasy or if something was really there. And you play a song from start to finish. I had nothing to do with it. You know, I feel you just happen to be there when it comes floating by. You know, I wrote Annie's song in 10 minutes on a ski lift. I wrote Calypso, the chorus I wrote the day that I met Captain Cousteau and the day that I first boarded the Calypso and the time it takes to say the words walking around that boat. Here was the chorus to a song, and I couldn't write the verses. I just couldn't say what I felt I wanted to say, you know? And I wanted to get it done. I was going to do a television show. That was the reason I was with Captain Cousteau in the first place. And I couldn't get it done for that television show. And then I wanted to get it done because I was going to go on a concert tour. And I had an orchestra with me, and I needed to have an arrangement for the orchestra for that song. I had to do it in concert. It wouldn't come. Finally, one day, I bagged it, went skiing, made about 2 runs, and all of a sudden, I just had to get back to my house and work on a song. I got in my Jeep. It takes 20 minutes to get from the ski area to my home in Colorado. In 20 minutes, I had the song. Walked upstairs, picked up my guitar, and played it start to finish. I have nothing to do with it. And it's so wonderful when one comes like that. I mean, I just can't tell you how great. Far out. So here's another new song, a love song. Called The Thought of You. It's been almost a year since that beautiful weekend. It was more than a lifetime ago. How it happens to mind after all of this time and brings tears to my eyes, I don't know. It's the thought of you and the way it can hurt to be so much in love. The thought of you brings it all my way. Sorry I called, I'm surprised to have found you at home. It's just once in a while I remember your number. I was hoping that you'd be alone
before I thought of you. And the way you can turn it around with a smile, the thought of you brings it all my way. And I know that it's over, but I can't discover a way to erase how I feel. I remember the nights and the passionate fights, and I know that I love you and I always will. And I need you to know that I'm always here for you, any day, any night, any time. It happened before, it could happen once more. There's a chance that you might change your mind, for the thought of you, how it feels to be safe here in your arms. The thought of you brings it all my way. And I know that it's over, but I can't discover a way to erase how I feel. I remember the nights and the passionate fights, and I know that I love you and I always will. It's been almost a year since that beautiful weekend. It was more than a lifetime ago.
I wrote that one on a beach, folks, just a song. I don't know. This is one I wrote in the shower. It's true. Title of the very first album that I recorded for RCA some 22 albums ago. It's called Rhymes and Reasons. So you speak to me of sadness, the coming of the winter, fear that is within you now and seems to never end, and the dreams that have escaped you, and the hope that you've forgotten. You tell me that you need me now, you want to be my friend, and you wonder where going, where's the rhyme, where's the reason, and it's you cannot accept. It is here we must begin to seek the wisdom of the children, and the graceful way of flowers in the wind, for the children and the flowers are my sisters and my brothers. Their laughter and their loveliness would clear a cloudy day, like the music of the mountains and the colors of the rainbow. Their promise of the future and a blessing for today. Oh, the cities start to crumble and the towers fall around us. The sun is slowly fading and it's colder than the sea. It is written, from the desert to the mountains they shall lead us. By the hand and by the heart they will comfort you and me. In their innocence and trusting they will teach us to be free. For the children and the flowers are my sisters and my brothers. Their laughter and their loveliness will
cloudy day, and the song that I am singing is a prayer to non-believers. Come and stand beside us, we can find a better way.
I'd like to do one more song, take a brief intermission for about 10 or 15 minutes. Invite you all to stick around and see the rest of the show. This is the Eagle and the Hawk.
Home to the place I belong.
in the morning hours she calls me. The radio reminds me of my home far away. Driving down the road I get a feeling that I should have been home yesterday. Look, yesterday. Country road, take me home to the place.
Just up off the floor, we used to go out to Grandma's house every month and so.
Have chicken pie, country ham, homemade butter on the bread. But the best darn thing about Grandma's house was a great big feather bed.
It was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, soft as a downy chick.
It was made from the feathers of 4 to 11 geese. Took a hole on the cloth on a tick. It hold 8 kids, 4 hound dogs, and a piggy we stole from a shed.
Didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.
After supper, we'd sit around the fire. The old folks would spit and chew. Paul would talk about the farm and the war, and my grand sing a ballad or two.
And I'd sit and listen, watch the fire, till a cobweb filled my head.
Next thing I know, I'd wake up in the morning in the middle of the old feather bed.
It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide, soft as a downy chick.
It was made from the feathers of 4 to 11 geese. Took a whole bowl of cloth for the tick.
It hold 8 kids, 4 hound dogs, and a piggy we stole from the shed.
Didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.
Yeah!
Well, I love my Ma, I love my Pa, I love Granny and Grandpa too. I've been fishing with my uncle, I wrestled my cousin, I even kissed Aunt Lou.
Ooh, and if I ever had to make a choice, I guess it ought to be said,
I'd trade them all, plus the gal down the road, for Grandma's feather bed.
It was 9 feet high and 6 feet wide, soft as a downy chick.
It was made from the feathers of 4 to 11 geese, took a hole on the cloth for the tick.
It hold 8 kids, 4 hound dogs, and a piggy we stole from a shed.
Didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.
We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.
I suppose you're wondering what this piano is doing here. Right about this point in the program, I am too. I don't know how to play the piano, folks. I'll be real honest with you. It'll be evident, even more obvious, in just a few moments. But I wrote this song on the piano, and I really like the song a whole lot, and I just, it's not the same on the guitar. I did it the other day on a television show, Pebble Mill 1. And I was sitting there at rehearsal, and all of a sudden there was a camera on me, and I realized that I'd never played piano in front of anybody before. Should have left it that way. This is the title song of my most recent new album on RCA. It's about two people falling apart. It's called Seasons of the Heart.
Thank you.
course we have our differences. You shouldn't be surprised. It's as natural as changes in the seasons and the skies. Sometimes we grow together, sometimes we drift apart. A wiser man than I might know the seasons of the heart. And I'm walking here beside you in the early evening chill. The thing we've always loved to do, I know we always will. We have so much in common, so many things we share, that I can't believe my heart when it implies that you're not there. Love is why I came here in the first place. Love is now the reason I must go. Love is all in my wildest dreams imagined it this way. Sometimes I just don't know you as a stranger in our home. When I'm lying right beside you is when I'm most alone. I think my heart is broken, there's an emptiness inside. Many things I've longed for have so often been denied. Still, I wouldn't try to change you. There's no one that's to blame. It's just some things that mean so much, we just don't feel the same. Love is why I came here in the first place. Love is now the reason I must go. Love is all I ever hope to find here. Love is still the only dream I know. Information, something you all might not know here in Great Britain. There are, in fact, four stages of inebriation. Charming, intelligent, invisible, and bulletproof. The reason I bring this up... A few months ago, I was out to dinner one night in Aspen, ran into an old friend of mine, a fellow that goes back quite a few years with me, one of my old skiing buddies. He taught me a lot of what I know about skiing. We used to do a lot of camping together and fishing and motorcycle riding and stuff like that. It seems that over the years we've not been able to spend quite as much time together as we used to. And also my friend has developed a little bit of a drinking problem. And the night that he sat down at my table while I was having dinner, he was obviously invisible and well on his way to bulletproof. Also, periodically during the evening, he would disappear off into one of the back rooms of the restaurant with someone or another of his friends. It was pretty obvious what was going on back there. Every time he came back by my table, his eyes were a little bit bigger, his speech a little more slurred, and his actions a little more like that. So I noticed all of this. The next morning, I happened to be out at the athletic club where I work out in Aspen. And after a good morning workout, I'd gone upstairs to make a phone call, ran into my friend having breakfast. And he was having a breakfast I couldn't believe. He had about a 16-ounce sirloin steak on his plate. He had 3 eggs. He had rolls just smeared with butter and honey. He was drinking coffee like it was going out of style. From the number of little white bags by the coffee cup, it looked like half of it was sugar. I asked him what was going on. He said that he had perhaps had a tad too much fun the night before, and he was trying to get himself together for a tennis match that he had coming up in the afternoon. I found out that evening that somewhere in the second set of that tennis match, my friend had a heart attack. I went to see him the next day in the Aspen Valley Hospital. He was in the intensive care ward there. When I walked in, I almost didn't recognize him. He'd lost all of his color. He had tubes sticking out of him everywhere. And really looked to be in bad shape, and I asked him how he was doing, and he said, "You know, John, I'm going to have to give up this tennis game, for it kills me." I suggested that perhaps it was not the tennis that he ought to give up. I'm very much into preventive measures, whether it has to do with health care or crime or war. And I visit the chiropractor periodically in Aspen, and I found in my chiropractor's office a poem that deals with the issue of prevention that I would like to share with you people. This is called "The Ambulance Down in the Valley." "'Twas a dangerous cliff, as they freely confessed, though to walk near its edge was quite pleasant. But over the side slipped a duke and a prince, and it had fooled many a peasant. The people all said something had to be done, though their projects did not at all tally. Some said put a fence round the edge of the cliff, others an ambulance down in the valley." The lament of the crowd was profound and so loud as their hearts overflowed with great pity. But the ambulance carried the cry of the day as it spread to the neighboring cities. A collection was made to accumulate aid, and dwellers in highway and alley gave dollars and cents not to furnish a fence, but an ambulance down in the valley. "For the cliff is all right if you're careful," they said, "and if folks ever trip and are falling, it's not the slipping and sliding that hurts so much as the shock when they're stopping." And so on for years, as these mishaps occurred, quick forth would the rescuers sally to pick up the victims who fell from the cliff with the ambulance down in the valley. Said one in his plea, "It's a marvel to me that you'd give so much greater attention to repairing results than to curing the cause. Why, you'd much better aim at prevention. The mischief, of course, should be stopped at its source. Come, friends and good neighbors, let's rally. It makes far better sense to rely on a fence than an ambulance down in the valley." "He's wrong in his head," the majority said. "He would end all our earnest endeavors. He's the kind of a jerk that would halt our good work, but we will support it forever. Don't we pick up them all just as quick as they fall and treat them with care quite liberally?
A superfluous fence is of no consequence if the ambulance works in the valley. Well, this story is queer as I've given it here, though things oft occur which are stranger. More humane, we assert, to repair all the hurt than the plan of removing the danger. Before it all ends, it's time to begin to attend to these things rationally. Yes, build up the fence and let us dispense with the ambulance down in the valley.